Nick's profile. Oh. Nick, 27, he's a drummer.
Living the single life, but I'm killing it.
Bummed I couldn't bring my pup with me, but I'm super stoked to meet you all. First round is on me.
#BigNickEnergy.
#BigNickEnergy. Okay.
Wow. Ooh, I like it.
So my only thing here is that punk rock bands, that guy is not a punk, but he doesn't even have a tattoo.
I need to tell you this. I'm into Linkin Park. He's one of my favorite artists.
No.
Angry, but you get a little emo and you play one Linkin Park song does not make you a drummer of a punk rock band. But see, right there, don't judge his character. He doesn't even have an earring.
But this is his profile. Maybe he wanted to choose a happy-go-lucky with a dog.
You're totally falling for the dog.
So, take me back to this.
Okay, so I know I look insane with my face mask on, but I just had to share this story. So bear with me. Okay, so I'm sitting here, I'm minding my own business. I see that The Circle has a season 3. And I start watching and I see this guy. Right. Okay, so like besides the obvious giant red flags, he's doing his intro and you know, I'm thinking, okay, this guy's like super douchey, but where do I know him from? And then he talks about being from Seattle and he puts his occupation as drummer because he wants to come off more relatable. And then his bio mentions punk and he says he's from Seattle. So if you know me in real life, you know I'm involved in Seattle's punk scene. I play in a band called Three Fingers and I run a little DIY fest called R-Fest, which the last 2 years I've had to cancel from COVID, so I guess I've only done it for 1 year, but I've tried and I fully booked a second year. Anyways, I digress. So I remember that when we were looking for a new drummer 2 years ago, who answered my Craigslist ad? This guy did. And then I was like, no, that can't be right. It can't be right. So I went back in my emails and I found, where's my finger? Here it is. I found him and he told me to go to his Instagram. So anyways, I remember immediately discussing it with a band member and thinking that the fact that he linked me to his Instagram instead of actual music recordings was first a giant red flag. And secondly, his Instagram was a fucking giant sea of red flags. It was all like frat style, like bro selfies. And then he had a couple video selfie style videos of him playing along to like popular tracks on an electronic drum set. Yeah, so I remember we were all immediately like, yeah, no. And we stopped responding to him, or like just didn't respond to him, I don't remember. But I'm dying watching this season, knowing how much of a bullet we dodged. And it does look, just from looking at his Instagram now, to like he's moved to Texas or something. So never saw him in the punk scene here, and I guess we never will. And so I do think we dodged a bullet. However, if he did join my band, maybe we would have gotten a shout out on Netflix. So I guess our loss.
Alert! Oh my god, yes! Danny Nick invited me to a private chat. Okay, this has to be good. Circle message. Smack my ass like the drum send. You can't send that. Damn, my bad, Circle. Okay, you're right. Circle message. Hi, Nick. I know that you're into blondes, parentheses, Isabella, heart emoji, and parentheses. But, in all caps, and I'm speaking for a friend here, do you like hairy, dark-haired women with tattoos who have a deep voice and can cook. Send. I'm disconnecting you.
Take away your things and go. Can't take back what you said.
Wait, because The Circle Season 3 is everything so far. And I'm just going to start off by telling you guys who are my early favorites. None of them. Yes, I don't care for any of these people in this circle because they did my girl dirty. And I'm talking about my good sis Michelle, because honestly, justice for Michelle. And I do want to say kudos to whoever was the producer that came up with this twist of somebody rejoining as a duplicate of Michelle, because that was chef's kiss. But how is it that they let Tweedledee and Tweedledum convince them that they were the real Michelle? Like, they were literally giving Hallmark generic responses to these questions, and everybody was like, oh my gosh, they seem so real. Meanwhile, my sis was giving specific, detailed answers, and they were like, oh, she's trying too hard. What? And I know y'all love Kai, but she low-key spearheaded the entire operation. And this messy twink switched up on my girl. And this man thinks the year 2000 was 2 days ago. I'm still not over this, but comment your faves down below.
This was hella shady.
I want to ask this question.
What the
because
heck?
I want to put pressure
and as
on
usual,
this player right
I
now.
Handled this
so people are more likely to rate her lower. My savage question is for Kay. Who do you think is least deserving of winning the prize money and why?
Oh, why do you put me in this position? Ooh, these are rough.
Hopefully other players see this and say, okay, that's who she'd block if she was influencer.
This could have come from Jackie? This is just seems like an Ashley question to me.
Yep, and it's shady.
I feel like struggling to answer this one.
I feel like everybody's deserving. But then I don't feel like that'd be answering the question. You gotta play the cards, right, Kay? Circle message. I believe that every single player is deserving of winning the prize money. I do believe that those who have had to overcome more of the circle's challenges deserve to really be considered, because these players have shown tremendous growth throughout the journey. Therefore, the least deserving player would be that who hasn't grown as much in the circle. And Sam.
The queen.
What a cop out. She didn't say a name.
She wasn't straight up about exactly who she's talking about.
Is that Jackie? I think she's talking to me.
No.
It probably would have been really shitty to see Jackie's name completely written out, even though this alludes to her.
Everybody's just sugarcoating everything. Ugh.
Last week, I saw my face in Times Square.
I love this man, and I have to have him.
Nothing is gonna come between our love, Judy. Nothing! Oh my damn it, Kevin!
Same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste.
You didn't cheat, but you're still a traitor.
God, I wish that you had thought this through.
Literally iconic. This is why he is my favorite.
Who is Isabella?
Who is Isabella?
Who is Isabella?
What a beautiful name.
Supposed to live, laugh, love in these conditions.
Let's check my entrance in the circle. Look at those shoes. Oh, booty on point. Okay, chin up, chin up. Yeah, get that good lighting. Work it. Shake those hips. Love it. Okay, now you've entered. Make an impression.
Daddy, sorry. Daddy, sorry. I mean, daddy, sorry. Daddy, sorry. Daddy, I mean, daddy, I mean, daddy, I mean, daddy, I mean, daddy, I mean.
Are you looking for a wife?
What?
Are you looking for a wife?
Like, what do you mean?
Like, just like a wife.
What's your point in putting hot sauce in the juice?
Just wanted to.
Okay, well, I want to fight you, so when you finish, meet me out here.
Okay.
All right.
Anyone else, like, not on the Circle TikTok yet? Like, season two, I was, like, an episode in, and suddenly Courtney was on my For You page. And then the next day, Savannah. Next day, Taralisha. Like, everyone was just there, and they were like, oh, new episode next week. We're so excited. And I know we're only on the first week of season three, but, like, where is Kay? Where's Roxana? Calvin, I'm dedicated to you guys now. I'm in. I'm ready to see you. I'm ready to see your lives. Daniel? Daniel has a TikTok. Where is he? TikTok's not working hard enough. I need you on my For You page right now. Where? I still get all the other people. Courtney comes up all the time. Joey and Sammy. Sammy comes up all the time. Where's season three? Work harder, TikTok.
She's obviously a diamond. I'm a bus token.
Period.
But I'm not going to use this picture.
All right.
Simply because I'm here single.
Hold on.
Gotta get him. Trying to be sexy.
Okay.
Oh, Lord.
We've all been in her shoes.